I will tell you, the day of March 2nd, it was beautiful in the morning. It was comfortable. It warmed up pretty fast. Got in the mid 80s. I came to work normal time, was prepared to go home normal time, but it didn't happen.
Instead, a 60-minute blur beginning at the end of former Henryville principal Troy Albert's lunch.
And as I was coming back, the clouds are starting to come in, but nothing real serious. And then we were watching, and we didn't get an alarm on our weather channels or anything like that, but I got a call from the superintendent, and he says, it's coming right at you.
And it was. An EF4 tornado tearing through southern Indiana and taking aim at Henryville High School.
We felt like it was the best interest for us to evacuate the building, so we dismissed.
Dozens were loaded onto district buses, delivered to a safer space, except this dozen.
There's a tornado right there, guys. Look, the funnel cloud.
That's a bus driver talking to her 11 students.
Guys, we're just gonna go as fast as we can.
Just moments after she decided to turn around.
Everybody got a book to put over your head? Do it. Get in the middle.
The bus, only a few blocks from the school, in a race against time.
Don't block me, truck. Don't block me.
Pulling into the school parking lot, surveillance cameras caught the mad dash as the students raced inside.
Go, 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 go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, come on, 11, go.
And then only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 seconds later, the bus starts to blow away.
It was a very loud noise. It was like a bomb exploded.
High winds wiped out walls, clearing classrooms, debris and damage left behind.
It's like a needle in a haystack. It just happened when we were picked.
But the reality is, the risk is real. FEMA finds Indiana to be high risk for tornadoes, averaging 22 a year. The state is in a red zone, facing winds of up to 250 miles per hour. And yet, there are no laws or building codes requiring Indiana schools to have shelters.
As soon as that siren goes off, we're like, let's get our kids safe.
We will now begin our tornado drill.
Keep moving, guys. Keep moving. You're doing a good job.
Brent Mitten is the principal at Brady Shrum Elementary School in Salem, Indiana. His building holds the only storm shelter in the state.
You can't. You can't put a price tag on it. You can't. So the $5 million, we can't. That's nothing for each student, each staff member that's in there. That's protected. You can't put a price on that.
Good job, guys. Keep it up.
Only 2 days into the new school year, his building is running a tornado drill, practicing to perfect a dance they hope they never have to do.
When we evacuate to this area for a warning, our process is we have usually about 3 lines coming through these doors and students going to their specific areas. And once we're in, the custodian comes in and shuts the door, and everyone's inside. We're safe from that point.
Safe from anything the storm could bring, with 4 classrooms, a presentation room, an emergency supply closet. 1,200 people could stay in this space for hours if need be during a storm.
We have hurricane-resistant doors. We have hurricane-resistant windows. And there's a sign on the wall that talks about it will withstand up to 250 mile per hour winds, and it says it's missile resistant. And as we've said before, we don't want to find that out, but it does say claim to be safe from that standpoint.
The safe room, which is an addition onto the elementary school, was funded partially through a grant. It's called the FEMA Pre-Disaster Mitigation Grant Program and aims to reduce risk from future natural disasters while also reducing reliance on federal funding in disaster aftermath.
The money's out there. Go out and find it.
Salem has their shelter, and Crawford County hopes to be next.
Nobody is exempt. You know, it's all of us. You have to be on guard.
More than 40 years in education, Superintendent Mike Key says safety is everything.
We're the biggest show in town. We house more people at any one particular time than anybody else in the county.
His hope is, with help from the FEMA grant, the school campus will provide a safe space to thousands in his rural county.
We're being told that we have a real good chance at this. This is why we are strongly pursuing And it would just be a really great thing.
Because in a state that knows the tragedy that follows a tornado,
everything's fine, and then next thing you know, it's just all gone.
There is no cost too great for peace of mind.
And you can't put that into words how much it means to protect everyone and keep them all safe. You can't do it.
In 2015, the International Building Code updated regulations requiring all schools built in the most tornado-prone part of the country to incorporate storm shelters in those plans. Indiana is one of about two dozen states that are on that list. They're one of only a handful that have not yet complied. Kentucky, Ohio, and Illinois all have regulations requiring schools to have those shelters in place right now. If you'd like to know how your child's district is prepared to handle a tornado, you can visit our website and click on this story. We have all of the information linked up right now. For Focus, I'm Shay McAllister.